What's this? Congress has paid out $15 million from sexual harassment slush fund to quiet victims. Talk about hypocrites. How can members of Congress stand in front of the press and TV cameras and on one hand say Roy Moore should resign, we don't need that kind of behavior in Congress, but on the other hand have a slush fund for sexual harassment that has paid out over $15 million to quiet victims? How insane is that? That's about as insane as mandating everyone in America buy Obamacare except them. Here's the report as told by Laura Ingraham on Fox News. Laura Ingraham's The Angle. Congress is spending your money to cover up sexual harassment. But first our top story, pulling back the curtain, sexual harassment inside the halls of Congress and how you're paying for the secret settlements. Sexual misconduct scandals have engulfed Hollywood, media, and now politics with the Roy Moore revelations. But did you know that you've been funding payoffs for congressional harassment claims for decades? According to the Congressional Office of Compliance, between 1997 and 2014, hundreds of women have been paid $15.2 million in total and awards and settlements for Capitol Hill workplace violations. The House Administration Committee held a hearing on the matter yesterday. As Jackie Speier stated, in fact, there are two members of Congress, Republican and Democrat right now, who serve who have been subject to review or not have been subject to review but have been engaged in sexual harassment. In addition, one unidentified female stated, this member asked the staffer to bring them over some materials to their residence and the young staffer is a young woman, went there, and was greeted by a member in a towel. It was a male who then invited her in. At that point, he decided to expose himself. She left and then she quit her job. Laura Ingraham then went on to introduce Jenny Beth Martin, co-founder of the Tea Party Patriots. Joining us of our reaction here in Washington is Jenny Beth Martin. She is a co-founder of Tea Party Patriots. She has a new piece on this growing scandal. And Scott Bolden, former chairman of the Democratic Party in Washington, D.C., and a former sex crimes prosecutor. Jenny Beth, let's start with you. This is so ridiculous. It's $15.2 million and this is started by a senator I really respect and admire, Chuck Grassley. What was the thinking behind this? We'll go through the procedures that women have to go through. President of the Tea Party Patriots, Jenny Beth Martin added. It was part of the Congressional Accountability Act, which, at the time, they were trying to make congressmen live under the law. So, they had passed including Title VII under Civil Rights Act. Martin went on to say. They are trying to make sure that they lived under several other laws and they also wanted to create something to deal with sexual harassment. But in doing this, they have instituted a culture of corruption and they have created much more intimidation for people who want to step forward. Laura Ingraham then introduced Scott Bolden, chairman of the National Bar Association, PAC. Ingraham stated, Scott, let me share this with you. This is the Office of Compliance, the steps a woman has to go through to file a complaint. First, the victims have 180 days to complain, that's not bad. You should get a little bit more if you are traumatized. Victims who wants to continue must start 30 days of mediation. So, they force you into mediation, then finally, the Office of Compliance Administration does a hearing, or you can file a federal lawsuit and it's all confidential. The problem, of course, is pushing women into mediation. It seems to be geared toward stopping the claim. If I look at this as a former attorney, this is kind of pushing. You don't really want to file this. Bolden added. This is all about power. Within the mediation, it's also a counseling pieces and when I first read this, I said, what are they counseling the women on? Either this happened, or it didn't happen, but again, this is all about power. Remember, elected officials on the Hill are products, if you will, and the other thing that you didn't show was the lack of disclosure unless they go to court. So, this is all very confidential and it's all about taking care of each other. As opposed to pulling the sheets off of it, if you will, and say, listen, we have a problem. I think the Republicans and the Democrats on the Hill have a chance to lead by fixing this. Laura Ingraham said, It's a slush hush fund. Don't say anything. Martin added, it's mandatory counseling. If you've been traumatized, do you really want your employer mandating that you must go to counseling before you can go to mediation? Recently, the Senate and Paul Ryan announced a mandatory sexual harassment training program is in the works, but the House hasn't had any push for any change, even though members of both parties have condemned Judge Roy Moore's accusations of sexual harassment. Ingraham went on to say. So, now the Senate is working on mandatory sexual harassment training in the Senate. The House still hasn't really been able to push through changes. I know Congresswoman Spire, who I usually don't agree with on much, but she's right on this. They want to get rid of that wait time for being able to push through and actually file an actual complaint. Bolden added, but, Laura, you know, in the reformation or the amendment of this legislation on both sides, you've got to make it uncomfortable for bad behavior. You have to be intentional about it. Again, how can members of Congress or the Senate come out against Judge Roy Moore's accusations on one hand, accusations that have yet to be proven real, and yet protect their own members with a slush fund for victims of sexual harassment using our hard-earned dollars to pay for it? Total hypocrites. I bet most taxpayers weren't aware of this slush fund. A slush fund that has paid out over $15 million to victims of Congress. Why should taxpayers fund sexual harassment suits for members of Congress? These members should have to fund their own damn lawsuits. Why are taxpayers responsible for members of Congress' pathetic lawsuits? What's really sad is this information took this long to come out. Most Americans, including myself, didn't even know this fund existed. Or that $15 million was paid out to victims of sexual harassment. Shouldn't we, the taxpayers, who funded these lawsuits for members of Congress, at least know WHO used this slush fund? How, when it was paid out? And why should this slush fund be used to basically quiet the victims? They should have called it hush funds. How pathetic. Women in Congress who have been sexually harassed should not be paid to keep quiet or made to sign a non-disclosure form or NDA. This is no different than Harvey Weinstein. As Laura Ingraham said, it's people in positions of power, who usually have some problem within themselves. Sad to see that the very members of Congress who vowed to boot Joy Roy Moore out of the Senate for ethical breaches if Alabama voters elect him, are the same members whose Congress, who have shelled out $15 million in sexual harassment claims. That's a $15 million taxpayer-financed slush fund designed to allow Congress members to go on sexually harassing on their own without penalty.